Hey guys, and welcome to the first hour with Darksiders 3, a new series of videos here on Experience Kills, in which I play through the first hour of a video game which I've never played before. And this time we're looking at Darksiders 3, a game that came out a little over a year ago, in which you continue the Darksiders story. Never been a big fan. Let me just check some of these settings, make sure the subtitles are on. Yep, all good there. And we're not going to waste too much time here. We're going to get straight into things. Start a new game. Balanced. I don't want this to be too difficult. A bit of a pussy when it comes to difficulty levels. Combat mode. Well, I mean, I'm going to go with default because it's default. No, that doesn't sound good. No, definitely not going to do that. And let's get straight into this, and then this is the first one of these videos, so as we go along, I'm going to talk a little bit about, I don't really know, my connection to Darksiders? Not particularly strong.
Why did the creator construct a
time for some lore. Time to catch us up on what's going on.
Misery. Sin. Among the scholars of both heaven and hell, this query is known. As the riddle.
I don't know about you guys, but I sense expositional heavy, long-ass cutscene.
A part of the grand design is not sin, then, by definition.
This is why I made sure subtitles were on, so you could follow along, even while I was talking over the video. So this isn't an edited video. This is literally the first hour of the game as it comes up for me. Warts and all.
The Nephilim. Spawn. Of angels and demons.
Can't say I have the strongest affinity for Darksiders. Played the first game a couple of times, never got that far, never played the second game. So I'm probably not the ideal audience for this, won't I?
Death, fury, and strife. The four horsemen.
There was quite a bit of excitement around this coming out, I remember that.
Inconceivable power
due to it being a THQ game and then it sold off and developed by someone else, Gunfire Games, who I think was made up quite a lot of the original studio, Vigil.
The Charred Council. Bear witness as the Council holds court.
Well, this is really going, isn't it?
The Nephilim War in the name.
It's kind of the thing, if I was playing this not for a video, I'd have skipped this. Pretty sure, as it's not doing anything for me. I know that's bad, but I kind of just want to play the game.
You are the juggernaut of all pain. Death, dark soul of eternity. You are the deepest.
I mean, at first, this art style was kind of cool. Now that this cutscene's gone on and on and on, it just seems a bit lacking in detail.
You are all that is unsettled in the hearts of that which lives and breathes. And finally, Fury, terrible engine of
cover of the game is anything go by. You play as Fury.
Are we to waste our time on ceremony, or are we to fight?
Step forward and recognize Horseman. You are the most impatient of your kin, the least predictable, dancing on the edge of your own.
So
reality.
Much like.
Your
scene setting, isn't it?
The
trying to give you like a shorthand as to characterization and stuff.
You.
Still talking! Shall I have Death fetch us some tea, or can we get on
it's
with
it? Clumsy way of starting a game.
Fury.
Storytelling, really, for me, should come from within the experience.
I wonder, will you light the flame of creation?
I don't know. I feel like there should be a rule,
stop
you know. You should have control of a character within 3 minutes of starting a new game. Minimum. Okay, so we've gone from out-of-engine cutscene to in-engine cutscene.
Dreams more thrilling than reality.
Had I known the new pact would be so exciting, I would have let war separate my head from my neck then and there.
Maybe that out-of-engine cutscene was added later when they realized this wasn't enough scene setting.
Rampage. Bored as I am, perhaps you're just lazy. If I didn't love you so much, I'd kill you just for something to do. The call?
Finally.
Hilarious joke about the horse there. Just thought I'd comment on that.
Please, please, please tell me you're a planet of demons that needs.
This is weird because we're back with these guys again, who were in the cutscene. Now, if I remember rightly, War. I'm trying to remember the story of the first game. I can't really remember it, but
yourself,
something to do with. Nope. I know War was involved.
Least favored of all the horsemen, but my tongue never found me chained to a rock like some dog.
And to be fair, to most people, coming to Darksiders 3, even if they came to it at release, it would have been a long time for them as well. Big old time difference between the second and the third game. Still haven't played the game, nearly 6 minutes in. Not the best onboarding, guys.
Apocalypse. Why would he...
We know not yet. As we speak, Earth falls beneath
and I kind of, like,
the hammers of heaven and the hammers of hell.
So the horsemen are to ride.
No.
Some of the voice acting here is not great. I'm not sure I like Fury's. These guys are fun, but it's so over the top, isn't it? There's no subtlety to this. There's no nuance. It's very cliched, everything here. And that's fair enough. Some people might enjoy this. Because it's being a game my wife would enjoy. Strong female lead. Gods and demons. Dark fantasy.
The balance between order
not really
and
my wheelhouse. Perfect game to choose as my first hour with debut episode. I say debut episode. There is another episode I may release at some point, but technical problems abound. Testing things out here, trying new things. Hopefully this one goes better.
I can handle those fools in my sleep. But when this task is complete, I demand that you grant me my rightful place leading the horsemen.
If you would trade obedience for a title...
I was thinking, as well,
but never
for interactive elements, I get to the end of this. If you guys want to see me continue my playthrough of the game, or if I particularly enjoyed that first hour, maybe I'll put it up there for discussion if you guys want to see more. But my intention is to just play the first hour of a bunch of games, go through my backlog, get some easy achievements, hopefully. Mostly on Xbox. I've set this up so far on Xbox. I can do it on my PlayStation as well, on PC, but this is Xbox, isn't it?
Van, you are the horseman. The only one that matters.
Enough!
Yeah, I'm really not feeling all this setup. This is kind of ridiculous. We're coming up not far off 10 minutes now since I launched the game.
Steadfast sight.
And the fact that I'm watching the clock this much and not really listening to the story kind of tells you everything about how I'm taking this.
Your quest for the seven deadly begins there.
It's probably really frustrating me just talking about these cutscenes.
Wait.
But I wasn't going to sit here for 10 minutes and not say anything. That would be a
whatever
bit pointless.
Pass between us, search your heart. You cannot believe I am guilty of these crimes. Something is wrong with the universe. Be vigilant, Fury. Forces conspire against us. Keep
for the love of God, let me play the game. If the next scene cut isn't into gameplay, I'm gonna do one. I'm gonna lose my mind. Loading screen. I remember the first game being kind of like a 3D Zelda, a little bit Metroidvania, simplistic combat. I'm down with that. Those kind of games can be fun. Okay, this is an engine. It's a good sign. We're landing on Earth. Yep. Let me hit things. Yes! I'm in the game. Jump, double jump. Kind of a bit of a lame double jump. Whip attack on X. Pretty standard, what you'd expect. Let's see how this fares with dudes. Yep. That feels okay. About something. I'll admit I didn't really read that. I'm so bored of waiting to play the game. I kind of just want to get into this now. Dodge is on RB. Yep, that's a dodge. Dodge, kind of, actually, I didn't expect to dodge. And the fact that they're kind of telling me about it so early on makes me think it's going to be important. I'm not a massive fan of games like that. I'd rather have a good parry. Let's see if that comes up.
Fury, we're close to one of the seven. I just know it. I hope it's
not. Okay. Strong moves based on good timing on dodges. Okay, I don't love... Come on. So I've got an indicator on the screen there telling me, oh, there's a dude off-screen attacking me. He's all a bit woolly. I'm struggling to hit him. Okay, I'm getting the distances down a bit here. Got to explore, guys. There's things on the floor everywhere. It's a healing shard. I know I meant to go up those ledges, I've just ignored. That's very obvious from the level design, but I am going to poke around because I need to know. Sprint is on the left thumbstick. Standard. I need to know if there's stuff to pick up. That double jump feels really like there's no high on it. Okay, we got swinging. I like that. That feels kind of good. Swinging on my whip. Oh, look at this, guys. Do you think it's a combat arena? Yeah, I think I'm going to do this. Now, I know I talked over a great deal of the cutscenes, but I'm basically hunting, I believe, the seven deadly sins. And this is why I'm on Earth. Because I don't care about humans. That tough lady.
Where exactly do we go from here?
Oh, it's a Skeksis.
I know not but what the council commands, mistress. The quest for the seven begins here.
That really looks like a Skeksis. A little bit less ugly, actually. Oh, Envy. So it's seven deadly sin, guys. Straight in to a boss fight, I'm going to guess.
Mine! Move on, horseman, for ye be mine too!
Yeah, let's see how this goes.
I'm on a mission.
Oh man, you know what it is this though? This is another freaking cutscene. I've played 10 minutes nearly of cutscenes, 2 minutes of gameplay, and then another cutscene. That's not good! That's not good on body, it's an action game! Let me play the game! Let me get a feel for the combat!
Quite the grudge you're carrying.
I'm just gonna have a drink here while I wait, because it could be a while.
When they have nothing left, they will be my playthings until they break.
Apologies if the swirling came up on the mic there.
Oh, I don't want to. Humanity is tragically overrated. I am not here for them. I'm all yours.
No!
Yep, boss fight. Okay. Right. More dodging. Tips. I mean, my combat options are really limited at the minute. I've got this whip and that's it. I have one button for attack, so I've got some combos, I'm assuming. Yeah, tell me about the dodge again. Important. First stage done already, that wasn't too bad. Straight into like a... Yeah, jump ledges, that's the way up. Is that the way up? That must be the way up. Okay, so jumping puzzle with this boss. Why do I feel like this is going to go badly? Because this jump does not feel good. The second jump feels almost utterly unnecessary. The swinging feels fairly intuitive, but I know I'm going to miss it at some point. That's just not inevitable. Right. Telling me how to heal. Okay. Yep. Oh, what? Okay. So it gives me a fucking tutorial prompt, which I'm stuck in, and then kills me with an AoE attack.
This is exactly what I desire.
Like, did a lot of damage on my health there. That's... frustrating. Mm, This is not, I'm going to be honest with you guys, this is not grabbing me right now. See how he fell off there as well. Sweet. And surely I have to get to that ledge. There's no way I can reach this enemy. Oh, what's this? What's... pushing buttons, trying to think about it. No. Again. So I've got half health. That AoE attack does about half damage, and I've got no way of healing now. Cool. Look at all that life bar on that enemy as well. So on the boss bar. So, I'm dead. AoE attack. You can't dodge or block. I'm dead. Okay. Right. Let's try that again. That was not great. Not great, guys. This is not a good onboarding experience. So 15 minutes from booting up the game, a little bit over that, I've already died. And I really understand how I'm meant to hurt that enemy. Call me, look, I'll be honest, not the most familiar with this type of game. Not my normal wheelhouse. Kind of why I wanted to do it first, try something I wouldn't normally. Fuck off. Fuck off. I'm at the start again. I mean, I know it wasn't very long, but that... why wasn't there a checkpoint before the boss fight? That's mad. Can I sprint through this? Can I just skip these enemies? Oh, because I really don't want to fight them all again. Let's see. Dodgy, dodgy. Oh, look at that. Sweet jumps. Yeah, skip you. It's the worst. Why did that not work? Anyway, yeah, I can get past it. Past it. I nearly missed that. Alright, she just sat there, so no, I don't have to do the cutscene again. Thank Christ for that. Let's try again. I'm already getting frustrated. Honestly, guys, if I hadn't committed to playing an hour of this, I would be quite inclined to just stop playing. I'm having trouble keeping track of the enemy here, I have to say. I've got to dodge, things. Cool, right. First stage done. What do we do? We have to work this out, guys. Kind of wish I was doing this live and you could tell me what to do. Waste one of my heals immediately. She's up there. What's this? What's this unlock on? I don't have any ranged attacks. I can't throw anything. I've got to get up there. So, this AoE attack is not proximity based then or something, is it? It must be timing. So I have to rush. I have to do this platforming quickly. Just gonna do it again. I mean, I've healed myself ready to take it, but and attack. Again. Why do I feel like I'm gonna die again, guys? This is fun, isn't it? We're all enjoying this. Right, okay, those aren't reaching. Damn, but that got him! Yes! Progress! So I had to get to that platform, and then attack him, and bring him down. Now I don't know where she is, and I keep getting hit by these area effect attacks, and... minutes in, and I want to quit playing this game forever. Really? Really, 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 really. I want to say I'm going to give this one more go And then I'm going to quit, but I'm not going to say that because I've committed to doing an hour of this. And I will do this. This is the problem I have. This is weirdly, like, not what I expected. This is way more like a Dark Souls. And I've just come off the back of playing a bunch of Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order and Sekiro. Not a big Souls fan. But this doesn't feel like a good one of those. Like, I don't know how to describe it. It's not what I was expecting. I was expecting a way more gentle onboarding, like, not here's the first boss, die a bunch, like you would in a Dark Souls game. And you're gonna have to learn stuff and practice. This is just I found something. That left trigger is a lock-on. Why was I not told in a tutorial screen that there was a lock-on? Now I can keep an eye on the enemy a lot more and see when they're pulling off their attacks. Holy shit! Why would you not tell me there's a lock-on? Why? Why? That's just... You saw how many tutorial tips I was getting. And again. No point have I been told left trigger locks onto the enemy. That's insane. Now I'm rushing. I'm going to try and get to Envy here before the AoE goes off. That probably means I'm going to miss one of these jumps. Nearly missed that one. Oh, really nearly missed that one. Oh, come on. Before it goes off. Spin, attack. Yeah, did it. Come on, eat my chain. Locking on. Jump. Bad. God damn, this jump is bad. Right, that one worked. Got over that. Come on. Nope, didn't dodge that. Still got a bunch of health though, guys. This is the best runs yet. I'm feeling good. Good dodge there. One of my powerful attacks. Oh, no. You see how when I'm locked on, my dodges are different? Because they're, you know, locked onto the perspective. This is way better. Oh my god, this is so much better. Why didn't they tell me about this? Alright, fourth stage? Is it fourth stage, I guess, at this point? Yeah, am I counting that right? Yeah, one, two. No, third stage. More climbing! At least I know that now this is kind of a thing where I have to run my ass off. Get to him. Swingy. Oh, into another swingy. Okay. Advanced level swinging. Come on, eat this. Eat my chain. Down! Locked on. Attack. So close! Jump actually successfully on missing. Oh, look at this. Now I know what I'm doing. Yes! Boss dead! The argument is, the Dark Souls logic is, that the highs are higher because of the frustration you feel getting killed and learning what you have to do. And that's true, and that felt good beating this boss on the third attempt then. But the problem there is that I was not told about a core mechanic of the game, which is the lock-on. Should you have to just push all the buttons until you find something on a controller in a game that is tutorializing how to double jump?
I did.
That feels a bit... Especially as, from what I remember, the Darksiders games were not like this before. They weren't about locking on and stuff and Dark Souls-esque combat. They were much more just hack and slash. I don't know. Is that right? Is that good? Do I just suck? I probably just suck.
This talisman.
It's a vessel. Envy used it to hold energy.
Don't love
the
this
rest
character.
Of the, seven.
The Watcher character.
It will make a
not a fan.
Prison for the others once their physical.
Clearly gonna be something in disguise.
If I may, there is a. Well, a
I actually just be one of the seven deadly sins. What do you think?
From the talisman.
Oh, yes, drawn to the talisman after we've just worked out the talisman is connected to the seven deadly sins.
So wise, you are all that the council promised,
what do you
mistress.
Think? I'm beginning to enjoy the sound of your voice, Watcher.
So that was kind of like... Uh-huh. Cool. Follow the guide on the thing. Simple enough. So that was kind of just like... the tutorial area, I guess. I might still be in the tutorial area. That was hard. What's this? Can I collect it? No. Okay. Just a thing. Fair enough. Let's move on. Keep an eye out for collectibles. Here's one. Don't know what they do. Oh, I know what a healing shard is. Yeah. Oh, I had other... Oh. I thought when I got a healing shard, it just healed me. But actually, it was a selectable thing with the D-pad there. I had more healing things than I realized in those previous boss fights. Cool. Once again, not really explained. Unless I was skipping through it because I'm bored of reading stuff. This jumping sucks. I do like the aesthetic of the world, though. The kind of...
I would be remiss in my duties if I didn't...
I'm slow walking.
Even with the talisman...
What the fuck?!
The other deadly sins will...
This is insane, guys. Right, just to put it in context, I've had, like, a hot 10 minutes of onboarding cutscene, followed by 2 minutes of fight, followed by another cutscene, followed by, you know, frustrating loading, followed by another cutscene upon the death. And then I've walked and jumped 5 steps, and now I've got a forced walking area, which is usually the higher load a la Gears of War, with more exposition and more cutscene-type dialogue. This is so fucking tedious. This is the opposite of what you want in a game like this. You just want to fight. Why? I mean, clearly these guys are up their own arse when it comes to their own lore. They think they are Shakespeare or something. It is not that good. I just want combat. I was just trying to talk about, I was going to say how I like the world, and I like this kind of broken down world that's, you know, demons and angels are all fighting it out in a big war and stuff, and therefore the earth has been ravaged. I think that's cool. It's got a cool art style, but this is just clumsy hand-holding that is really boring. Oh, big chasm. Don't want to fall down there. That looks like... that thing in front of me here looks like something. What does it do? Do I stand on it?
I knew that war...
Maybe it will become something. Because if I remember rightly, this is Metroidvania inspired, so you have... elements that will be gated based on abilities and based on skills and stuff like that. So I suspect we'll come up to some locked doors. That's how these games usually work. They like to telegraph what you're going to be able to access at a later point. Legend. That is. I picked it up. Don't know what the souls are for yet. I'm guessing, considering the sort of souls-like combat, souls will be the currency at some point. I will spend them on something. Another lurcher clump. Let's have a little explore. I like these enemies. They're low level, and I can fight them and beat them easily. I know I'm only half an hour in, but I feel like I've been playing for days at this point. And, you know, if this was God of War or something, I'd have had different combinations on X and Y and stuff, different ways, or triangle in God of War's case, different ways of fighting enemies, some variety, probably a ranged weapon by now, something to mix up the mechanics. Can I get over there? No, it doesn't look good, does it? I reckon if I try that, I'll die. So let's just push on. This does look a bit strange, this game, because remember, so Darksiders 1 and 2 were both re-released onto the current generation and looked dated because of that. This, however, was developed, like I said, it's a bit over a year old, developed for the current generation hardware. It looks dated, doesn't it? The geometry, the level design, the quality. Can I get up there? No, this jump sucks. I keep forgetting. My jump sucks so much. Just the quality of the geometry and obviously Fury looks pretty good because she's the main character. They spent a lot of time on her. But the rest of it looks just a bit dated. Like, you know, it speaks to the troubled development of the game, which was obviously in development prior to the collapse of THQ, and therefore they've inherited a bunch of assets which have been, like, you know, I'm guessing, you know, worked on and up-resed and just improved a little bit. But Yeah. I'm talking about the assets right now, because I basically don't need to play the tunes as well. And simple and easy. These enemies are easy. It's so strange after that horrible fucking boss fight situation. Oh, swing, swing, swing. Swing, swing, swing. Okay. Here's an unnecessary first person bit that doesn't feel good or look great. Why are we doing this? Who knows? Must be to hide a load. Can't say I love the design of the demons either. The zombie dudes are alright, but these guys look a bit... I don't know what they were. Little zombie henchmen. They're probably like human, fallen humans. These guys. These ones, they look. They don't look scary. They don't look particularly demonic. I'm assuming they're meant to be demons. Oh, these rage guys are annoying. Look, they just keep going backwards, kiting you and fucking you up with their disky things. They're not fun to fight. Look at that, look at that, look at that. That is gated progress right there. Gated progress. So I'm going to get something at some point that allows me to come back here and get through that if I so remember or care, which I probably won't. Combat arena. That's kind of frustrating as well. Like, you just get there and you go to jump in, and the enemy immediately jumps out. I'm having issues with this still. I mean, I've obviously know about the lock-on now. But the way the enemies attack you from off-screen and the camera being in so close, it's frustrating because you have to sort of just guess, especially when there's multiple enemies. Maybe I'll get something that deals with that better later on, I don't know. Oh, another gate of progress, let's have a look at this one. Red. Cobwebs. What's that? Oh! That's a man, that's a guy. Oh, shit, that guy did a load of damage. Oh Christ! If I die again. Oh my god. Now I can't get away from him. Ripping through my health potions here. Fuck! What am I gonna do here? There's, well, not much else I can do. Whippy whip whip. Try and dodge, I guess. Some seriously powerful attacks here. They're just ripping through my health. Remember, this is still like the tutorial area there, guys. You know, I've not been told anything about advanced combat. Not been told about this lock-on. I wonder if I'll ever be told about this lock-on. Come on. Come on, you've got a bit left on that bar. For a non-boss enemy, he takes some punishment. Jesus. Can't even get anything, really, for that. Some of the souls. Oh, no, I've got nothing to heal myself with. Oh, goody, a lurcher clump. Whatever that is. Yeah, I can't. I keep forgetting. My jump sucks. Not gonna get up there. Oh, my health.
Perhaps there are humans.
Do you know what else, guys? I have a red bar up there, and it's flashing, and I have no idea what that means under my health bar. No idea at all. I'm guessing I will be told at some point, as we're still in tutorial land, but it's a resource I could be using, but I don't know what it is, and I can't be bothered to look in the pause menu right now. And now we're in Haven. Okay, that's a big, that's a really big tree.
Or is it out of place here?
It is a maker tree. Most likely we will find refuge.
Oh god. Don't want to fall off these, eh? Pretty sure I'm gonna. Wait for this. best I didn't review this. It's really, really not clicking with me at the minute. I'm still trying to find some fun here. It's level design. It's really bland, isn't it? Oh, what have we got? What's this gonna be? It's a dude.
Aren't we making a mighty ruckus?
Okay, I can guess that this is a merchant immediately from the way he's speaking. It's so cliched in the introduction.
Well, such a passionate little thing, aren't we?
Do not test my...
I'm just such a bitch. I'm so mean.
War is too hazardous an occupation for myself, Horseman.
Well, you know what? That was a fairly lengthy, unbroken sequence of combat there, wasn't it? I've been clamoring for that for a while to get me into the game a little bit. And there was some time with the combat. I fought four enemy types. So I fought the grunts, the melee demons, the ranged demons, and the big dude, who kind of came out of nowhere. But I did get hands-on with the combat. And it sucked. So, it doesn't suck. It's obviously going to develop and improve and get more complex. I mean, that's the nature of these types of games, but you shouldn't test and, you know, hone the combat backwards from when you've got everything back to the basic stuff, just because the early stuff then feels like crap. And that's what this does. It feels like crap. It feels super, super basic and super, super crap. Really, really uninspired. We found the merchant. We know what we're going to do with our souls now. Oh, okay. That thing I found, the one I found earlier was one of these. Yep. So I can travel back to him. Okay. I mean, once again, Metroidvania, so I can go back with, Serpenthold. I can buy healing stuff, but I don't buy a lot of stuff. I don't know how much of it is, really. What's this? Oh, okay. Okay, so I can respec. But right now, I think, yeah, that's the fast travel thing. That's the one I found earlier. Lots of them are locked, because the indication of how many locations there are.
As you wish.
Let's feed him some souls, baby. Nom 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 nom. Yep. Exciting stuff. Just doubled up. Let's have a look how I do what I do with that. Start.
Do make
not
sure
start,
they
how is it where it's called? Menu. Here we go. Health, definitely health. Yeah, gonna be health, I think. Oh, it's a menu screen, so I've got, that's my weapon. We're going to get other weapons, probably. Got ingredients and stuff. I'm not even going to look at that. It's just, here are your attacks. Everything's X. 1X, 2X, 3X, 4X. Oh, God, yeah. Nothing that exciting, really, in that menu. Let's progress. Loving all this jumping. Really what I'm here for.
They live to confound and feed.
How would this building fall down like this? I don't understand the logic of this design at all. Look at it. It's all like, it doesn't make sense. The floors are just sort of just holding themselves up, and they're falling down in these handy ramp type. Where the fuck am I meant to go here? Have I got to get over there? How do I get over there? I can't get over that. I came from down there. Sweet level design, guys. Loving this. Really intuitive. Is that a thing? Oh. How was I meant to know? There were some scratches on it. Okay. Am I just sucking? Or is this as bad as I think? No, I'm honestly not sure. Oh, I found it. Okay. Let's climb along the woods. God, I'm really scared of falling off this. I don't even know if I can, but it's like I don't want to try it in case I'll fall. My jump gives me so little leeway because it's so shit that I hope you can upgrade it. Oh, that's another gated thing. Finding all these lovely gated passages. This is great. And so far, you know, I haven't actually found anything to unlock any of them. We're coming up for 40 minutes in, probably because most of that time has been cutscenes.
The length these roots have grown. They seem to have taken over everything.
Indeed.
I mean, this is kind of cool in a way. The idea of the design here with the roots going through the city. It reminds me a bit of the Kashyyyk level from Jedi Fallen Order, obviously. After this, I'm going to say it vastly superior as a game. I don't know if it's fair to compare and contrast those two, but at this point, what's that like? See that? There's a gusty wind thing there. I bet that means I can ride that at some point. But not now. Maybe I get wings. That'd be kind of cool. I'm just glad there's only 20 more minutes left of me having to play this. Self-imposed torture. That's what we do here. That's what we do at Experience Kills. For your enjoyment, I've decided to play games that aren't very good. I mean, that's the point of this series, though. I'm playing games that I haven't played yet. I literally have sat in my backlog. So there's probably a reason that they have sat in my backlog. Like, some of them will be games I've bought just, you know, like this game I bought it in a sale, and it's just sat there. You know, because I'm addicted to purchasing video games. Let's investigate this building. God, it's a lot of things. Jump. Underwhelming! I thought I was going to find an amazing secret then, and instead I found another lurcher thing. I still don't know what they do. I can't imagine many of you guys are even watching this, because who's going to fucking YouTube search Darksiders 3 a year after release? This is more of a beta test of the format. Mostly just for me. If you are watching this, and you've got 45 minutes in, sorry. It's not very good.
I'm curious as to who remains here, if anyone.
Have I got some souls to bank? Let's bank some souls, baby.
Greedy. This will be fun for both of us. As you wish. Do make sure they scream, Horseman.
I sense a cutscene. God, I'm an expert. I just know these things.
Behind me, wee ones. Let me tend to our uninvited guests. A Horseman.
Fury, currently reserving the right to kill you where you stand. And you are?
Surprised. Oh. And more than a little relieved. Call me Ulfane Blackhammer.
So you'll not be flattening me today?
It's a human.
A maker, are you not?
No, he's a maker.
Aye, one that's something.
It's another thing,
to
I guess. Today, my skills not just a big human. Kind of like a big dwarf.
No, not theirs neither. Like your council, I care for balance, Horseman. Schumann's
wow.
Frail as
that is some like post-apocalyptic fashion right there, isn't it? Look on those guys.
Surely you're here.
Ooh, hoods and rags, baby.
Wrong question.
A tribe of useless, hairless simians whose greatest burn is inventing
ingenious she really doesn't
new
give a shit
ways
about
to
humans.
Divide and destroy one.
But I bet she's gonna learn to love they them and develop a heart of gold over the course of this 20-hour campaign that I'm not gonna play.
What is your business here?
What do they call
it's interesting, it just speaks to how important first impressions are, doesn't it?
Question me.
If you came to this like I have and you're not an existing fan of Darksiders.
Around.
You're just gonna bounce off so hard.
Do you honestly think anything scares me now?
Easy, lad. This one's none for trifles.
Yeah? What do I have to lose? This moronic conflict makes you all look so stupid. Angel, demon, horseman, even maker. What are you even fighting for, huh? Tell me.
I bet you. I bet you she's like, you're alright. Yeah. Ah, Jones is cool. Jones has got a spunk.
Horseman,
so Fury please. Likes him.
To have you on our side would turn the tide in ways we cannot measure.
Do you know what? Humanity. They've spent a lot of time on her character model, but she's well, so overdesigned, isn't she?
Involve balance. It does like, not require them.
What I am here to is going on with her
the armor. Seven deadly sins and return them to the council. No less, no more.
What if I can help you?
He's the blacksmith who can upgrade my gear.
I sincerely doubt that. I'm faring quite well without any help.
Of course. But in case you missed the moniker, I am a maker who specializes in instruments of destruction, chaos, and the deliverance of pain. So it stands to reason that we little Ulthane could enhance your arsenal if your horsemanship would give me the chance.
In exchange for?
Humanity will not survive without aid.
I've gone quiet because I've just run out of things to care about.
If you come across any humans on your journey, please direct them here.
This is so tedious.
It's the only place they might be sufficiently protected.
I actually quite like how Maker looks. I wish I was playing as him more than Fury.
How do you expect the apes to cross a battlefield and find you?
Oh, I don't.
I should probably build first Darksiders again. The bridge. That's basically what war looks like.
Humans can use it. One touch. They're sent to Haven.
So I'm teleporting humans back to him as a form of currency for upgrading my gear. Sure.
I accept your offer, Maker. Though I doubt it will make your collection any less useless.
Well, I mean, I would be if I was going to play this game for longer than a little.
We have a non-deal, then. As a show of good faith, a gift.
If you're wondering, I just have a timeline. Because it's like,
you seek a pit of hell.
I can't torture myself any further.
Beneath the city. And please, horseman.
Yes, yes, I will shepherd the wee ones your way, pointless as it may be.
We'll see.
It's shocking to me how little of this game I've actually played and how much I've
had to watch. Doors of Haven stand open to any who ask.
This first hour. Really shocking. Cool. Oh, she's big. Must be the Maker's wife.
Welcome, horseman.
Let's explore. What fabulous secrets might we find? Oh! Did that wrong. Do you think... I think this place will probably... Do you think it'll upgrade? We'll get busier? More full of people? As the game progresses? That'd be a nice touch, wouldn't it? I might be slightly overestimating the abilities of the developer in that regard, but you never know. Oh look, gated progress. I get it, because it's meant to incentivize you to push forward and get the gear and stuff and full damage. No full damage. Good to know. But it's a bit frustrating at the same time, isn't it? It's a difficult balance. You don't want to show too much of it like that. But I mean, Jedi Fallen Order did it as well. And in general, it didn't bother me. I think I'm just hating now because I'm bored. It's not the lore or the world I'm interested in at all. So
just another pawn who will never understand the game into which he's been played. And he does love the sound of his own voice, doesn't he?
Not like anyone else.
Slightly
did you
bigger environment,
something?
Perhaps. A little bit more open, a bit more hubby. There we have the dude. Yeah, gonna have to go to get Sin over there. Let's explore. Let's find out what's around. Dude. So, I predict the loot is like farm the souls. Upgrade, spend time in combat so you can upgrade your abilities and level up, become more powerful, and then you'll find the progress is easier, I'd imagine. I imagine those big dudes, that one that fought me earlier, I will, within 3 hours or something, like, fight them with just half a dozen hits and a win, and they won't do any damage to me. Look, gusty thing again, gusty thing. Clearly I need some way of elevating myself. Oh shit. Just came out. To be fair, there was one wall, so hang out on the wall, so I should be able to do. Oh! Upgrade currency. Cuckoo. Oh look at this. What do you reckon? That a wall jump ability there? Gotta be, innit? Now, if you all leave in the comments, Ben, please play more Darksiders 3 just because you're horrible, horrible assholes. I'm mainly. Fuck! Oh, Jesus. Just running away. Let's try and use that before the end of this video. Oh, he's got a range attack. I'm dead. I didn't even know he had the ability to throw boulders at me. Screw that guy. And where, pray tell, will I have to go back for this loading screen? Back to the beginning again? That would be amazing. Can you imagine? Can you imagine if this put me back to the beginning again? Oh my god. We're under 10 minutes now, guys. So I'll probably be wrapping this up quite soon. Oh no, okay, I'm back in that area. Thank Christ. Let's explore a different direction or something. Yeah, let's go down here. Wait, I'm professional enough to put I have muted it. So you may or may not have heard that. Exciting content, I'm sure you're loving this. Oh, I can't hit him. I guess that means I'm gonna get down. Why is this guy fucking me up so much? What am I doing? Well, I'm losing the will, is what it is. I just can't be bothered. He's gonna kill me. He's probably killing me. He's letting him follow me and kill me. So, for no reason then. I like messing up their lunch. You know, it's the kind of horseman I am. Ooh, a wrath shard. Whatever the fuck that is. Oh, he looks different. Yeah, he's different. Oh, this is not good, is it? What am I doing? Dodge, get away. That's the last of my health, I think. Lock on. Oh, and I dodged. That's skillful. Ballerina of death. That's me. Oh, shit. Oh, I did it again, though. I did it again. I'm under half health in the way. Oh, nope. He's playing keepy uppy here. Oh fuck him. Wow, that attacked me a lot. Jesus. Ah. Oh. I'm dead again, guys. Oh, this is torture. Okay. 5 minutes! Need to show you guys some of the powers I seem to have got. Wrath, was it Wrath Form? Need to do that. credits loads. Quite long load times. Long enough to be annoying when you keep dying. Because you suck. Like, this jump is so shit. I keep expecting it to be better, and it's just not. So maybe this area is a bit more indicative of what the rest of the game is like. These open areas that are traversable at your own leisure. I should look through some of this, I suppose, yeah. Oh, it's the lurchers! Like all the lurcher clumps. What do they give me? I think they give me souls. Let's go back to the shop, man, and find out. Yes, they do. Shatter those. Oh, lots of souls now. Level me up, baby.
Greeting. This will be fun for both of us.
I will be the best I can be now.
As you wish.
I'm not doing anything with the arcane stuff yet. So I'm going to go right up to the hour point, but I'm going to just say now, I hope you've enjoyed this video as we're approaching the end of me torturing myself playing this game. Hey, but I didn't know I wasn't going to like it. So that's the whole point of this, is me going through my backlog, trying out these games. Please give us a like and subscribe on the YouTube channel. There will be no audio versions of these videos because this is so involved with exactly what I'm doing on the screen and what I'm playing for this hour. So they'll only be enjoyable. Which is good. But anyway, yeah, you check us out on there. We don't monetize in any way. There's no advertising. There's no Patreon. Please like and subscribe. That is all we ask for. It really helps to get the word out about us. I'm going to try and run over here. Kite as many dudes as I can and pull off one of the big attacks. Let's see what happens. Boosh! Eat it, bitches. Yeah, see, that was kind of fun. That was cool. He's still alive, though. That guy's still hanging alive. I have to try and beat him. Right. Come on. But yeah, this is a new thing for us. This is just me chatting away. There's normally Experience Kills is two voices, two people, me, Richard, me and Cameron. Obviously, this is just myself. Something to do, get through my backlog during the quiet months. You know, if people enjoy it, I'm open to continuing these things and just doing them. I want to do it roughly once a week, play an hour of a game, chat over while I do it. And yeah, it's just a little bit of fun, not too serious, not a proper review, just going through that, my backlog, my games I've bought in the sale, maybe games I've got for Game Pass, things like that, and just trying things out. So I hope you enjoyed it. Please leave us some feedback. You can do it on YouTube, but you can also tweet at Experience Kills or at myself, at DIYE. Just, you know, let me know. I'm just checking now as well, that over here were items. And yeah, they're not there anymore. So once you've got them, you've got them, even if you die. So that's good to know. In a way, this bit is making me enjoy the game a little bit more now. Now that I have a better understanding of the game, I think this first hour has been bad. I think. Didn't know you could do that. Good to know. That's another way of getting souls. You can break the big floaty ones. But yeah, this first hour hasn't been a good onboarding. It really hasn't, has it? So, I know, I'm going to go, if we've got time, I'm going to try and rush, we'll see if I have time, and before this hour is up, because I'm really being setting a deadline on this, and use this big fury form. I think it's LBRT, which is not the best button combination. Let's see if we can get over there in time and try out quickly. Yeah, we'll do against the big dude. Let's see what happens. And that's how we'll end the video. 30 seconds. 30 seconds, there I am, rawr, fury! Ending this video on a big swoosh of death. I hope you've enjoyed this. Leave us some feedback. Hopefully this one technically has gone better than the first one. But we'll see. You might never see it. Fingers crossed you do. So I've been Ben. Have a good one.